Chop, chop.
You have had your three shredded wheat this morning, Miss Pierce.
I had a gulp of tea.
Caesar wanted to see what was better, to run full or empty.
What?
He dispatched two messengers, one hungry, one just fed.
What? Why?
When they arrived at their destinations, they handed over their messages and were immediately opened up and killed to see.
Oh, that's disgusting. You're making that up.
Scout's honour.
So what happened?
I can't remember. Doesn't matter. Come on.
But your doctor's in town. I thought we'd go that way.
Come on.
So we think, just hang on a minute, we're here.
You just have to come with me and we'll get to where we're going. We've got plenty of time.
Was it the Armfield practice or Weston?
Are you coming with me or are you going to be all scratchy?
Well, I don't like this. It makes me feel anxious. But I'm not going to make it.
Come in with me.
Everything about him is right. All I need to do is make him see that we're right together. I mean, what's the point in pussyfooting around? I mean, why sit at the side in the dance hall of life when all you really want to do is get up and boogie?
Boogie.
Is it manic and needy? To be honest, no, my feelings are valid. You're right. You are so right. I just need to hold my nose and jump.
Right.
And if he thinks that I'm pushing him to go too fast, then, well, I'm just being direct. You know, I've got to know how he feels. It kills me when he seems distant. And do you think that's his way of going off me? I mean, what could I have done wrong? Am I crazy to want to trust him? Would you trust him?
Okay, listen.
This is our building. They build them too high now. Too high is too much wind. These are too high. It's wonderful. Look.
At what? What are we looking at?
The wonderfulness.
Okay, I've had enough. Which practice is it? Either you stop this now or I'm going to go home, all right? I'm not doing this. What are you playing at? You trying to freak me out? Because if you are, it's working.
You asked.
And you couldn't help yourself, could you? You had to look at the worst of it. You had to see the dark side.
Simon!
You see those nasty little plastic spikes? Rows and rows of plastic spikes.
Is it 9 o'clock?
They put them there to stop the starlings from roosting. They put them there so the pigeons have nowhere to rest. Spiteful. I'd tear it all off. I'd say, come on, city birds! Come and rest here! Squawk and flap and poop! Squawk and flap and poop!
Stop it. People are looking.
Good.
No. No. It's not good. We don't behave like that.
Oh, no, I forgot. Mental patients. Not allowed to be worried about the birds, are we? That might make us mad. They should think about the birds.
Do you want to get us into trouble?
We're not going to be late, because my appointment, Miss Timekeeper, is for 12.
12?
Noon. Midday. 12 o'clock. Did I say 9? When did I say 9?
So, what do you think it's going to be like up there? Just enough breeze?
I haven't had any breakfast and neither of you come up with going home.
They shouldn't stop the birds. We should do something about that. Wait a minute. Okay.
St Paul's Cathedral was the tallest building in London in 1900.
I didn't say that he was keeping anything from you. I said that I thought that possibly he might be.
Are you ever going to let me forget it?
Forget what?
That I thought Scott was married.
This has got nothing to do with Scott.
And you choose to rub my face in it now. You must really hate me for that.
I don't hate you. You were looking out for me.
Oh, are you sure?
Simon, don't. There just may be things that Will doesn't want you to know yet, that's all.
Like what?
I don't know, things.
Things? What things? That he's what? He's an illegal immigrant? That he's a secret millionaire?
The one, no, he's married and living in Smethwick. He's got 4 kids by 3 different women. Oh, no, I know what it is.
I only said, if you think that there's something odd, then maybe there is. That's all. Shoot the horse if it makes you feel better.
It shoot the messenger. Of course, the saddest thing is you becoming so suspicious and cynical.
I only said...
You're so busy looking at problems in everybody else's life, you don't see the problem in your own.
Which is?
You're turning into a total... Zara. Only without the wit.
Crayon?
So, what should it look like then?
Thanks for that.
Yeah, that should shift it on a damp cloth. Yeah, I'll just go back to bed. Sorry. Thanks, Julia.
And the award for the most convincingly chucked sickie goes to Miss Ruth Pierce for her excellent performance in I Feel All Fluey, I Just Can't Seem to Get Warm.
I wouldn't have had to lie if you'd told me what time your actual appointment was. I could have taken a day's annual leave. Thought I'd be in by 10.
Only now you don't want to leave me on my own?
I wanted to come with you, so I'm chucking a sickie.
So you're not hanging around because you don't trust me, then?
Of course I'm not.
You don't think I need mothering?
No.
Good. Right. Then you should know that, after a great deal of thought, I've decided not to go and see my GP after all. In fact, I never made an appointment.
I heard you on the phone. You made the appointment.
You told me!
We all tell lies!
Not to each other! Not you and me! Not about important things! Do we? What else have you been lying to me about?
I just wanted to talk about Will. I'm sorry, I like saying his name. I like saying our names together. I'm sorry.
It's all right. I know, I do get that.
If I don't go for it with him, I could lose him. Say something positive.
I'm sure that you have got nothing to worry about.
Come on, should I go for it? Should I not go for it? Do you want us to be happy?
Of course I want you to be happy.
No, us. Me and Will, Cherry. Me and Will.
How can you be truly happy when you are not well? What are the lies?
Who does the judging? Is it an illness when your senses are heightened? What's diseased about wanting to be elated? You know what meds do to you.
You were on the meds when I first met you. You were fun and exciting then. There was nothing dull about you.
And you were catatonic. Remember that? I know you remember that.
I needed help.
And you got meds!
You've stopped, haven't you?
I'm rejuvenated. I can hear the wind, the movement of feathers when birds fly overhead. I hear, Ruth.
Oh, you can tell the doctors that because they just want you to be well.
Why am I not allowed? Why can't I listen? They just want to keep me stuck down. Gluey, deaf brain, pinned and stuck down where they want me to be. They lack capacity and I don't fit into their parameters. Therefore, they have to fix me, smash me, stick me into the floor with their injections, drown me.
Without your meds, our meds, we can become volatile and unpredictable. And you know that. And you've been lying to me.
So I stopped. I'm only trying to be free.
How long since you went for your last injection?
Feeling is believing.
Oh, it was just us.
It is.
I want you to talk to your doctor. You have to give us a chance, Smithy.
It's easy to be happy when you're medicated, behaving like they want us to. Trust me.
I'm not pretending to be happy. When I think about us, when I think about how it could be, if you weren't... Why are you doing this?
I've got to go.
What? Where?
To pee. What? Do I need a note from my mother? Do you want me to leave the door open? You gonna come with me?
Of course not.
What am I gonna do? Flush myself? Do you really want to come with me? Come on then, come with me. Make sure I'm a good boy.
I trust you.
Hi.
Look, I was gonna call you.
Look, you might want to sit down for this.
Okay.
The thing is, I really thought that we were going somewhere.
Am I being dumped?
No, it's not that. It's just, I can't stand the suspense anymore, the angst.
You are dumping me.
No, stop it.
Well, say what you called to say then.
I love being with you. You make me laugh.
And I smile about us when we're not together.
And I have these sort of mental Polaroids which I can flash up in my mind, pictures of us.
Together.
Doing what?
Well, that's what I'm going to tell you when you meet me for lunch. We're going to talk about what we're doing, where we're going, and what we want.
That's a lot of the we word.
As my grandmother used to say, it's time to wee or get off the pot.
Okay, I'll see you at the Icon Bar.
Okay, well, I finish early, so make it 1:30.
Yes, boss. It's pee on the pot.
Do you want tea or coffee? Smithy? Smithy? Smithy!
Simon, could you see Mrs. Pendry? I think that she might need some more antibiotics.
Yeah, of course, no problem.
Thanks.
Oh, by the way, I'm having lunch with Will. I'm gonna have that heart to heart. I'm meeting with the Icon later.
Jack's working there today. I thought I might pop over myself later.
I decided, on balance, to ignore your dire words of warning.
Or maybe not.
I'm not going to apologise for offering my opinion, Simon. Not when you asked for it.
Well, perhaps you'll have the good grace to apologise once you're proved wrong.
Smithy?
Smithson's Emporium of Dreams.
Noah Smithson speaking. How may I direct your call?
Where are you?
On top of the world, with cloud music and memories. I told you, I'm taking the spikes off.
The starlings will come back.
Smithy!
He's got his knickers in a twist because he wants it to work.
Well, how is being nasty to me going to make that happen?
Well, no, you're thinking logically. I mean, he's brains are in his pants, his heart's in his mouth, he's got butterflies in his stomach, he's sick with excitement.
I know, so he should be in a good mood, which proves my point.
Come again?
Somehow, somewhere, he thinks that something's not right.
Right.
So, something must be wrong.
Darlings know you trust me. You understand. You get it.
I just love you. You look so tiny. Ah!
Yes, I'm in the foyer now. We're supposed to be in my meeting at 20 past. Excuse me. Who's responsible for visitor parking here, please?
Should have given you a token when they booked you in.
What?
Where are you going?
CHC PLC, fourth floor.
Rat! Thought I was going to drown. I was the drowning man. But here, I can breathe. Breathe this. There was a young lady named Ruth, who always told the truth. She believed in the pills, though they gave her the chills. But she saw the grand design. Come on, let me show you. This is the best ever. This is it.
We can breathe.
Get down.
Who's going to breathe with me if you don't? Only you, Ruth. You know it's only you.
Come and see. The birds are coming back. Look. I won't let you fall. Please.
Please.
I don't want to go up there.
Ruth. I'll set us free.
I can't.
Help me.
I can't sit there because I am too frightened.
Please.
I can't. I can't. I'm sorry!
Ah! Hey, you're right. Julia said you got the flu. Do you want me to bring you something? Okay, I'm coming. Get Cherry to cover my house calls. I've got to go.
Okay.
I want you to sit down.
Who'd you call?
You could fall.
I won't fall. Who'd you call?
Sit down!
Sit with me then. Why should I sit down when you don't trust me?
Now, please sit down.
Shake the pills, the dullness, and all their filth out of your mind. Close your eyes and find the truth. Dare you? Shake it off!
Gave you extra feta. No pressure, tip boy.
Excellent.
No more pontificating and procrastinating.
How's that?
I may be about to make an enormous pillock of myself. I'm not prepared to do that while you're chewing. I'm not taking one step forwards and two steps back with you again. I want this to go somewhere.
Hey! Go! What do you think you're doing?
Michelle!
Michelle! Michelle! You're thanking God for bringing Nat here. Did you call her? Did you call her?
I just...
You called her?
Ruth!
Ruth, will you please get down from there? Look, she's asked me to help you.
You? You, you're a toxic, poisonous cow.
Hey, 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 mind your mouth. And get your backside down off there, you mad kid.
Look, it's all right, I can handle this, yeah? Smithy? Can I call you Smithy?
Smithy, please!
You're scaring Ruth. You don't want to scare Ruth, do you?
Why are you talking to me like I'm an imbecile? You don't want to scare Ruth, do you?
You nasty sneak.
I'm sorry.
Don't want to hear you.
Hey! What's this? Did you pull this off? Get out before I pull you down. You're paying for this. Right, that's it.
No, look. He's not well and he needs help. What I need you to do is take Ruth inside. Ruth! 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 Come here, Ruth! Ruth! Look at me, look at me. I need you to call the beaches.
Make a call, Ruth! Who are you going to call, Ruth?
He's looking for a slap. I'm calling the police.
Will you just calm down?
Look, he's not safe, do you hear me? We need to keep him safe.
We need to lamp him one.
Will you please just shut up? Ruth, you know what you have to do, yeah? You need to call Trudy.
You need to call Trudy.
It's the only choice that we have, yeah? Please, will you take her inside?
I don't need any of this.
Do us all a favour, mate, and jump.
I'm putting it out there, no more dithering. I'm not hiding my feelings, I'm not playing any games. I'm just gonna jump, okay?
Well, that kind of makes me responsible for catching you.
Kind of. Well, you don't have to say anything now, and, your lunch should be getting cold.
It's a salad. And, I thought we were done with the dithering.
Well, anyway.
Anyway. Do you really think I could eat now? There's only one thing I'm hungry for.
Not having no fruitcake jumping on my watch. How'd that look on the CV? How'd that look on the pavement?
I couldn't help him, he needs them. I had to call them, they're mental health professionals.
Not nurses. Oh, good. There was a bloke, jumped off the one across the street in November. Still said they're staying at Christmas.
Not as if you're anything special. Look at you, all boobs and backside. All fake hair, fake everything.
Has obviously paid off, and because of that, he's able to take advantage of a couple of blunders by Minora.
Of course. You're too much of a wimp to come close to a woman like me. Do you think I'd purpose someone like you? Of course not. But, Ruth, let's do what you want, though, eh?
Shut your great, fat mouth.
Oh, poor Mousy Ruth and Smithy the big I am, yeah? I know, right? I see you.
You don't. Shut up!
Listen, Ruth. You know that Smithy needs us. We can get him through this, just like you got through it. I should go out there. I should be with him. No, that's not going to help, not either of you. Please, stay here. I will look after him, I promise you. Strap him up. Get him well again, because that's what I do, Ruth. That's why I'm here. You know this. This is why you called, isn't it? And you knew you were doing the right thing. Did I? Why do I feel like a Judas then? Stay here, Ruth. Please.
You all talk, Smithy. Why don't you come here and say it to my face?
No. Not her. What are you doing here? Not now!
She's here to help.
Hey, Smithy. Come on, what are you doing? Frightening everybody, man. Come here, let's get this sorted out.
Do you like it up here, Trudy?
There. No head for heights, me. Come on, lover, do us a favour.
Where's Ruth? Have you taken her away? Ruth! Ruth! What have you done with her? Where is she?
Turn to my English rose for nobody.
tempt me from shame. I sailed the seven seas, flown the whole blue sky, but I return with haste to where my love does lie. No matter where I go, I will come back to my English rose, for nothing can ever tempt me from she. I've searched the secret mists, I've climbed the highest peaks, and caught the wild wind home to hear a soft voice speak. No matter where I roam, I will return to my English rose, for no bonds can ever keep me from she.
And your whole life working your way up from a gutter. And the gutter moves in across the road.
Balance and stability. Smithy would say they're part of the grey door world, more like death than life.
You weren't even going to pay my house visit until I took the lead. And then you follow me over there, only because you're worried that my professional conduct would show up your own glaring inadequacies.
I find you snooping on me again. You're going to regret it. Big time.
Well, I am sorry about...